Well, when you taste wine, you taste with all of your senses, right? It's not just your taste buds. In fact, you only taste sweet, sour, bitter, and salt with your taste buds. So that's why you want to taste out of a glass so that you can see it, because that's the first sense that you do.
Okay.
All right. And the next thing you do is swirl it, and it's not to look like a wine snob at a cocktail party, which is never a good idea, right? But you actually are swirling it to aerate the wine. Because you'll collect the aromas in the headspace of the glass, and then once you smell it, which is the next S in wine tasting, you'll have all those aromas to be able to capture. So go ahead, give it a swirl.
Wait, a swirl.
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 Yep. So you see, swirl, and then you sniff.
Okay.
And so much of the taste is in the smell, so give yourself a chance to really soak that in. And what you're first looking for is that the wine's in good condition, right? So it doesn't have any flaws, it doesn't smell musty, things like that. The next thing you're looking for is for the wine to smell to your taste and smell like something you find pleasant. And if you're tasting a quality wine, the chances are really good that you are gonna enjoy that smell. Now, you know, it may not be able to distinguish between different grape varieties or styles when you first start tasting. That's okay, it's not a big deal. What you're first looking for is just for it to be a style that you like. The next thing you're gonna do is sip it. And then professionals really swirl the wine around in your mouth because that helps to aerate all of the aromatic components so that you can appreciate all the layers of flavor. So a lot of times people say they can't tell the difference between wines, but that's just because they're going too fast, right? So go ahead and give it a try.
And this is a part that's interesting you're talking about tasting, because it started off, people just sort of taste it like this.
Mm-hmm.
But then some of the sommeliers and other people have made it almost an art form. I mean, I've literally seen people that recommend you kind of like swirl like this.
Whoa.
It's gotten pretty extreme.
Yeah.
What do you think is the ideal amount of swirling and
I'm not the X Games of wine tasting, so I like to sort of keep it pretty low key. What you're trying to accomplish actually is just to aerate the wine in your mouth, because where you get flavor is actually from your sense of smell. And if you aerate the wine in your mouth, then all the aromatic components that are in it can travel through your throat up into your olfactory bulb. And that's what's going to tell you cherry, which is what I get in this wine. This is a Pinot Noir, you told me.
Yes.
Right, so there's a lot of cherry flavor in there. And so that's why you're going to do that. So I just aerate it slightly. And then my other big thing is after I swallow the wine, or professionals often spit it, I exhale through my nose. And that gives you the additional detail and layers of flavor. The other thing you'll want to really do, of course, is best you can, try to taste from a good glass. Now, if all you have is a Dixie cup, that's okay. Maybe, you know, on a picnic, you'll get
some
by.
Some wine in a bad cup is better than no wine.
No, exactly. You're not going to say no to it. But when you have a chance to taste from a decent glass, that's really going to help to optimize the wine and focus the aroma. It's going to help you to be able to see the wine and enjoy that. And that's really what you're looking for, is to make the most of the wine in the glass. Oh, do you not use headphones?
No.
Action.
This is how I got my
little bit TMZ.
So, yeah.